Alright you guys, this is part 3 and what I had to do was erase a little bit of part 2 of my collective haul, and so I can't remember exactly what part I had to cut, so I'm going to start again from the Wet n Wild that I purchased on recommendation of everybody and their mama up in YouTube. It was recommended to purchase the eyeliner Wet n Wild number 886, which is the black one, because it's very comparable to the MAC Black Track Fluid line. So I did purchase that and I tried it and I like it. You put it on and after you put it on, this thing don't budge, doesn't move, and it's so black. So this is very nice. What else did I get here? I went over to Big Lots, because I've always, you know, I see everybody else buying hauls from Big Lots. I rarely go to Big Lots to buy makeup, but I said, you know, I said to myself, let me go this time around and see what I find. So I went and I found just the other day, it's the Revlon, yeah, I need glasses, the Revlon Age Define Instant Firming Face Primer, and I got this. It was about $3.50. I haven't tried it yet, so I'm going to give it a shot and give you my opinion on it and see how that works with my makeup. I also went and purchased the Revlon Age Define Makeup Concealer Compact with Botafirm. So I've been using this. I kind of like the way it works. It's cool. It's all right. It works for me. And I purchased that, and I also went and purchased I also purchased the Revlon powder blush, and this one is in Tender Plum. It's kind of light for me, so if it's light now and it's winter and my skin is lighter, you can be assured that in the summertime it's going to be a little too light for me. So I went on ahead and also purchased number 435 Merlot at Midnight Golden Affair, and this is a sculpting blush, also by Revlon. So I went on a Revlon kick, and this is what it looks like. You guys, is very pretty. The gold dots there, they it's like a gold shimmery color, so when you pass the brush over everything, you get a very nice burgundy color with some golden shimmer on it. But now here's the thing, I tried this and it's a bit too dark for me, but it does work, believe it or not, as an eyeshadow. So the gold on the inner corner and the burgundy all over the rest of the lid, so that works. If you guys see something flashing, that's my daughter, she's taking pictures. But you know what I did was that I combined this with this together, because I'm not going to say, well, I'm going to get rid of this because this is too dark, this is too light. I combined them together, and this is the color that I have. Okay, let me see if you can see it. And it actually gives me a nice pinkish look on my face, and not a dark pink, like a mauve, like, me explaining, fatal. It's a nice, pretty, rosy, almost mauve-ish, but soft color, nothing too outlandish. So I combine these two, works for me, I like it. The next thing, I also purchased on recommendation of Makeup by Kathy. You should check out her videos, guys. She's such a nice person. I like the way she explains what she's doing, and also the fact that she has a very cool sense of humor. I like her sense of humor, so. And I'm always writing something, some comment up on her page. On her page, like we're on Facebook. Something up on her channel, you know, and she always laughs about it. But anyway, on one of her hauls, she had recommended, or she mentioned what was her new favorite nude color in lipstick and Revlon. And she said it was Almost Nude, which is number 117. Yeah. I went looking all over for it. I couldn't find it. I guess the color may have been discontinued. And so, by coincidence, when I was at Big Lot, I found it. So, what I can tell you about this color, It is a shade, just a tad shade darker than the Revlon Soft Nude. And I'll try to put these two together. See, you can see it there. Okay, all right. Just a shade darker. I like the one. So I like the one. I like them both. They both work for me. And that's my daughter, Thalia. And I like it. And now when I combined this 117 with the Midnight Swirl from Revlon, and this is Choc au Latte, which I also purchased at Big Lots. When I combined both colors, man, the color that it gave me was awesome. Can't touch. Get away. Okay, come on, Thalia. I need to do this in 10 minutes.
Keep this in the video.
Okay, I will. All right. So that was my purchase from there. So far I've covered Ulta, CVS, and Big Lots. Now, from the dollar store. I purchased from the dollar store a couple of lipsticks. And I found, you guys, let me start with this first. I found the Maybelline Dream Mousse Eyeshadow. I picked it up in number 40, which is Tranquil Rose. Number 55, which is Tropical Breeze. Number 60, which is Blue Heaven. And number 155, which is Rose Kiss. I'm going to tell you straight up now. I didn't. Put in my hair. I didn't like it. It has a weird consistency. I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna do. Let me do the blue shadow, the blue one, because that's like really, really blue, 1977 blue.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, just taking it out of the container. See? Can you guys see that?
Okay. This is boring.
No, you did not do that. In my next video, you're going to see me tearing her up. Stay tuned. Anyway, you see this. Thalia, don't start with me. You see this, and it's the consistency, it's I don't like it. And then when you put it on, I'll put it on over here. Man, this thing can run because it's so almost oily-like. And it's supposed to turn into powdery, but you still have that oil behind it. So I'm kind of afraid to even use it as a base. I saw a video where it said to use just a little drop of moisturizer and combine it with the moisturizer, and it's supposed to work. So I'm gonna try different ways and see if I can make this work, because I refuse to get rid of it. But if I can't find a way, then I don't know what to tell you guys. But I personally didn't like these. Didn't work for me. So, let me put those two aside. And, oh my goodness, already 8 minutes have passed by. Time flies when you're having fun. I also picked up from the dollar store the Sally Hansen. It's a lipstick, and it's a funny, it's a weird way, because it has a lipstick consistency, but it comes in a lip gloss type of applicator. Okay, so when you put it on, it actually has the color of a lipstick. So I purchased in Santeen and also in Linen. Linen is more of a almost a brown nude color. Well, nude for me. Okay, I don't know if you can see it. Anyway, that's the color. I like the smell. It has a very decent smell to it. And the consistency is pretty decent. For a dollar, you can't go wrong. Also from Sally Hansen, I purchased a Satin Effects lip gloss. It really doesn't do much, so just another lip gloss. Now, I'm going to have to go to a part 4. Can you believe this? Man, I'll see you guys in part 4. Bye.